What's coming in on the Kerala gold scandal? The Congress party, which is the opposition in Kerala, has upped the ante against the Kerala government, pushing for a CBI probe into the Kerala gold scandal as more and more details tumble out, which is not looking really good for the Kerala government, not certainly for the Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan himself, given the perceived closeness with Swapna Suresh and many others, including MSF Sivasankar, who was in fact the principal secretary IT to the Kerala Chief Minister. Now, Ramesh Chenithala, who is the Congress leader in Kerala, has demanded a CBI probe and has in fact increased the chorus for a CBI probe given the sensitivity and the seriousness of the charges in the case. Let's take a look at some reactions coming in. Here's Ramesh Chenithala.
I feel that there is a more, Chief Minister of Kerala is having moral responsibility in this case. He should be questioned and his office should be questioned. Then only the real facts will come to the light. This major controversy and the major scam which happened in Kerala is having lot of ramifications, not only in India, in UAE and other parts of the world also.
Vivek Karandilam joins us now. More on this. Vivek, the Congress now upping the ante, pushing for a CBI probe, given the fact there are more and more details coming out about the perceived proximity of both Swapna Suresh, M. Sivasankar and the couple of other accused to the Kerala left ruling LDF there.
That's right, Athar. The CPM, I mean the Congress party, the main opposition in Kerala, and has been mounting the protest and also the pressure on Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan right from the beginning, right from the day one onwards. That's on 6th of July when this case had come to light, and when there was allegations against M. Sivasankar, who is a close confidant of Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan. Now he's been suspended and there is an inquiry against him. Now what is even more shocking is that the Chief Minister's office is under the scanner of the customs officials. Initially, the Congress party has demanded that the various CCTV footages in the Chief Minister's office needs to be checked. Even the BJP has been demanding that. But the Chief Minister, right from the beginning, has been refuting all such allegations and saying that these are all wild allegations, has nothing to do with the party, and he's come and he's very, very clear on that. But day by day, it looks like the involvement of M. Sivasankar in this particular case is becoming more and more clearer, because if you go by the statements of M. Sarith, who's been questioned by the customs initially and by the NIA now, it clearly shows, what we understand from the sources is that, what Sarith says is that he was in touch with M. Sivasankar right from the beginning. And also, M. Sivasankar was aware of the smuggling which has been happening. Now that clearly shows that M. Sivasankar cannot wash away his hands. And also,
Vivek, stay with us. There are some other aspects of the story now that we are getting reactions on. The STPI has denied any links of its activists with Swapna Suresh and the gold smuggling probe. Here's Abdul Hamid, who is a functionary of the STPI, speaking on the issue.
The right-wing panelists was misusing the photograph to tarnish the political party STPI. The reason, it is very clear. We are the forefront of anti-right-wing fascist agenda in this country. We take strong exceptions to allow a panelist raise false allegations to a party.
So the SDP denying any links of any of its activists, Vivek, to those who have been in fact either charged in the case or are being investigated in this case. This is another aspect of it. They say it's something of a conspiracy to malign them.
Exactly, Athar. Now, this is in regard with a picture, which has come out from, which is in Facebook, where Rahul Ishwar, has raised initially. He said that this picture clearly shows that Swapna Suresh did have contact with STP activists. Remember, this picture was taken in 2018 when, the UAE consulate members, including Swapna Suresh. So, remember, at that point of time, Swapna Suresh was working under the UAE consulate and they were supplying certain food kits. And, some STPI members are also seen along with her. Now, it's on this regard that this allegation had been was raised. Now, STP has completely refuted this. Now, coming back to this particular case, what we understand is that various CCTV footages of the hotels and also the residences were Swapna Suresh and Sandeep and Sandeep and Sarit had stayed in Trivandrum is being procured by the NIA officials, and also various neighbors who were staying near that flats has been questioned. What we understand is that the NIA has got some crucial information to substantiate their claims at this point of time. Only once Faisal Farid, remember, he's a person who's been arrested 2 days back from Dubai by the Rashidiya police, and once he's been taken back to India to question, only after that the clear picture will emerge, because he is supposed to be one of the main kingpin in this case. What we understand is that he's a person who's been handing over the gold, the baggages which consist of gold, to India. So he is a person whom the NIA and the customs believe was very, very close with these accused, especially the second and the fourth accused in this particular case.
Right.
So that is going to be very, very important of, bringing back Faisal Farid back to India and question him and to get the complete information of this particular case.
All right. We also have some more inputs coming in on the story. Vivek, stay on.